KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
All right, lots of cool things to talk about. If you think the weather never changes around here, think 2 days ago, Sunday, was 70s and 80s, beautiful weather today. Highs mostly in the 50s, barely eked out a few 60s, which is a little below normal for April, but you usually don't expect warm weather this time of year. Last year, at this time, we were in the middle of a heat wave. Santa Cruz was up to 96 degrees on the 20th of April last year. Today, only 62. Salinas, 99, 40 degrees cooler today. King City made it to 100 this time last year, about 3 or 4 days, actually, around this time of year, only 59 degrees. So, yeah, I guess a year can make a big difference. 75 hundredths of an inch of rain, 3/4 of an inch in Boulder Creek, darn near that Scotts Valley, 60 hundredths at Don and Ben Lomond, 62 for Santa Cruz, a little less in Watsonville. Across the bay, Monterey Peninsula, almost 3/4 of an inch, give or take there, Marina and Seaside. Monterey at the airport, 65 hundredths, but 92 hundredths in the climate station there that Bob Bernard's been keeping an eye on. So a pretty good downpour there, and a little over 1/2 inch in Pacific Grove, Carmel, and Carmel Valley, almost an inch, Big Sur, 94 hundredths. Salinas Valley, 59 hundredths in Salinas, all the way down to 38 hundredths in King City, with 1/2 inch still for Gonzales and Soledad. Most of that from that front this morning, so that was a good run. We got 51 hundredths in San Jose, a little bit less in Morgan Hill and Gilroy, 3/4 of an inch in Hollister, which usually gets less than everybody, so it was a nice run. There's the front, the rain, and now the showers with the upper-level low moving through. Still have a few coming in from offshore because the low is still offshore, as I showed you at the top of the newscast there. It's still pumping in a few showers, so it's one of those things, you see those pretty cumulonimbus clouds that look like cauliflower in the sky, and that's because there's a nice cool air loft for getting that vertical lift, and that produces sometimes hail and some lightning. So far, not a lot of lightning strikes, though, so that's good news. 50s and 60s for high temperatures today, where just 2 days ago we were doing 80s. The 80s are pretty much left to Las Vegas and Palm Springs, and Phoenix was up to 89. Boise made it up to 83, while Seattle was only 56. 59 in Denver, but then lots of 70s stretching all through the middle of the country and some 60s, the upper Midwest to the Northeast. Have an upper-level system here, cranking in some showers and thunderstorms from about the, well, Ohio Valley, Tennessee Valley, all the way down into Florida, getting some good rain. A couple of boomers over the Plain States. No severe weather of any great consequence yet, though. And meanwhile, we're getting that snow up in the high Sierras. That cold front moves into the high mountains and gets a little extra shot. Tomorrow, that low is still with us. You can see the closed circulation of this upper-level trough here at the 18,000-foot level. Then a little high pressure here, but still some thunderstorms on the leading edge of that. A little low will keep some active weather going in the middle of the map there. We're still doing a little springtime thing. And for us, just waiting on this swirl to move on through. The front is already passed. Now we're on the backside, but still some energy there. But behind it, high pressure. So what you see is not what you get for the weekend. As you can see in our future cast here, we're going to trade that low pressure system, drier skies, and a high pressure ridge just in time for all the fun and frolic. So it's still timing out pretty good. Little bit windy along the coast, says Microcast. Most of the valleys and the mountains won't see all that much, but it'll kick up a little bit. So the farther you go out to sea, the rougher it'll get. Mariners, take heed. It's going to be pretty choppy out there for at least another day. And it's going to be cool for just about everybody. Lows in the 40s, that's not too bad, but highs mostly in the 50s. For another day with that cool air mass that this upper level low brought by. So we'll figure something on the order of about 57 to 59. Might sneak in a couple of 60s, but we'll only do this for another day. And before too long, those will be your overnight low temperatures, and it'll be called summer. It's just part of how we do things around here. But all told, it's still pretty good. No frost to worry about, by the way. So that's good news for growers and gardeners. Partly cloudy, some passing showers through the night. Locally, a little bit windy, mostly along the coast. Likewise, again, tomorrow, the valley's not quite as breezy. Variable clouds, some scattered showers, cool and windy. We'll do it for one more day. And after maybe a couple of sprinkles in the Santa Lucias on Thursday morning, most of us will get partly cloudy going. And a little bit less wind. And overnight lows staying in the 40s with a few upper 30s for a few more nights, but by the weekend, back into the 40s we go. And along with that, any showers are done with by Thursday morning, and we'll likely sit high and dry right through the weekend. Beautiful weather, 60s and 70s for highs. We have a chance of some rain Tuesday and Wednesday, but the models are already kind of waffling on that. Some north, some say maybe. So we'll just kind of hedge that one for now and see what happens. Kind of winding down, but so far this has been a great little rainy season for us. So.
Yeah. It's been perfect. We haven't had too many problems. We got lots of water.
Yeah, lots of water.
Wildflowers look great.
I know. Everything's green. Yeah. California informal wear. Just in time for the prime.
Fair enough.
There you go.